Hi church, and welcome to day 21, our final day of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. I pray that God has blessed you greatly, that you felt stronger in your faith, and that God has been moving in and through your life. And I believe that as we've done this as a church, that we'll begin to see God move in great and mighty ways. This isn't going to be the end of our prayer and fasting. We're going to keep praying. We're going to keep calling upon God as a church. I'm hoping that we'll be able to do this again later on in the year where we set aside specifically 21 days. But let's as a church keep praying, keep believing, keep calling upon our God, because prayer changes things. And as we fast, God changes us as we dedicate our lives to Him and humble ourselves before Him. So I pray that God has blessed you greatly over these 21 days. And today we're going to be praying for faith for miracles. This is the final day of our prayer, and this is what we're going to pray for. And it says this in Matthew chapter 19, verse 26, the words of Jesus. Jesus looked at them intently and said, "Humanly speaking, it is impossible, but with God, everything is possible." I'm so glad of that today, that with God, all things are possible. There's nothing too difficult for Him. And you know, when we spend time discovering who our God is, when you spend time reading through the Word, you'll discover how powerful He is, how mighty He is, how He's created this whole earth, how He created you and me. And when we think about that, when we think about His power, when we think about His strength, when we think about how Jesus overcame the grave, how Jesus is alive, then that should fill us with faith to believe that there is no situation that comes our way that is too difficult for our God to change. You know, I'm so glad that Jesus says that even faith, as small as a mustard seed, can move a mountain. And maybe you're watching this today, and maybe you're feeling surrounded by an impossible situation. Maybe the enemy of your soul, maybe Satan, is bringing about doubts to your mind because of a situation or circumstance you find yourself in. Today, I pray that God will raise your faith, that God will lift up your faith. And as you turn and fix your eyes on Him, you'll believe that God can change that circumstance, that God can change your situation. You know, one of my favorite songs that we sing as a church is Waymaker. And you know, it says in the chorus of that song, "Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are." You know, when we read of miracles in the Bible, oftentimes we can think that God only performed miracles in the past. But I want to encourage you today that our God hasn't changed. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And He's able to perform a miracle for you. No matter how desperate the situation, no matter how impossible it seems in the natural, with God, all things are possible. And I'm praying for a miracle. Let's pray for miracles today. Would you join with me and let's call upon God for that? Amen. Lord, we thank You that You are the miracle worker today. Lord Jesus, You are the God who changes water into wine. You are the God who opens the blind eyes. You are the God who raises people from the dead. There is nothing that is too difficult for You today, Jesus. And Jesus, we fix our eyes on You. Yes, the situations that we face in ourselves, oh God, might be difficult, oh God. For us, it is impossible. But I'm so glad today, Lord God, that with You, all things are possible. Give us faith today, I pray, in Jesus' name, to believe for miracles, even faith as small as a mustard seed. I pray for every person who's watching online today and they are facing the impossible. Lord Jesus, I pray, change them situations today. Lord, those who are bound by addiction today, I pray in Jesus' name, would You set them free? Those with illnesses today, I pray You'll bring about healing in Jesus' name. Those who are facing impossible situations in the home life, Lord God, I pray You'll bring about breakthrough in Jesus' name, Lord God. Those, Lord God, with unsaved loved ones, oh God, I pray in Your name that we will see salvation for full households, Lord Jesus. People turn into You. For our nation, we pray in Jesus' name that we will see our nation turn to You. Lord, we pray that COVID will go today in Jesus' name, for You, the God of miracles, Lord God. So Lord, we place our faith and trust in You. Lord, whatever it is, Lord God, You know. Lord, I pray that every person online today would receive a miracle. Lord, would believe for a miracle. May we as a church, Lord God, keep believing for miracles. May we not become complacent just to accept what goes on in our lives. But let's call upon You, Lord God. Give us faith to keep trusting in You, to believe for miracles. Move in our land, move in our lives, move in our community, I pray. And Lord, we ask that You would perform these miracles so that your fame would resound, that your name would be declared right up and down our valleys, oh God, and right across this world, oh God. We ask this for your glory and in your name, Lord Jesus. Lord, we just thank you for these 21 days of prayer and fasting. And Lord, we know that these days aren't going to be in vain, Lord God. As we sought your face, as we called upon you, Lord, your word says that you will answer our prayers. So we're asking, Lord God, answer every single prayer today. Answer every single one of our prayers over these 21 days. And change our nation, change our community, change our church, change our lives. Lord, we ask this for your glory, for your honor. We thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Well, what an incredible joy it's been over these last 21 days to join with you every day and just to spend some time praying. And I want to encourage you, today isn't over. Keep praying today. Keep fasting and calling upon the Lord and believe and ask God for faith, for miracles. But I want to thank you for joining me every day over these last 21 days. I pray that God has blessed you, that God has spoken to you. And I'm believing that God is going to answer every single one of our prayers. And we're going to keep praying as a church. That's one of our values as a church. We are a praying church. It's not our last response, it is our first resort. We're going to call upon Jesus as a church. So I want to thank you, and please know that as a church, we are here for you and praying for you. I look forward to seeing you again very soon, and I hope you have a great week. Take care. God bless.